We were committed to do the 4,004, but it was limited to BusyCom. But we had another customer come in, Computer Terminals Corporation, initially asking for a memory chip. And Stan Mazur was the main contact, and it turned out they were building what they called a glass teletype, but it was sort of a smart computer terminal that had a processor in it. And this memory was part of the processor. And so Stan says, well, you know, what's the rest of the processor look like? Mm-hmm. And they show him the instruction set and everything. And Stan checked with me, but we both said, I think we ought to do the whole thing as one chip. And that ultimately became the 8008, our second microprocessor.
And that was Vic Poor and his guys down Victor from Poor. San Antonio. Oh, I remember I'd been down and seen
Wait, in fact, they later changed the name to Data Point. The terminal they were making, they called the Data Point.
I actually worked at Data Point for a while.
And so anyway, one of the things that was unique about that proposal was they said they did not need to have it limited to their own use. They said, mm-hmm. we will use our early knowledge of it as our main advantage, but we figure if you sell it to other people, you'll have higher volume, and ultimately the cost will be better for us, and we'll use that early advantage. We'll know better how to use it than our competitors do. So in effect, that meant that we could offer that as a product. But there were many objections to doing it, primarily from our marketing department. Now, we got first parts on the 4004, is actually a set of four chips, CPU, two memories, and an I/O chip. First parts were available early 1971. And one of the things that we had always brought up with marketing is that this entire design is done by Intel. Mm-hmm. It wasn't something brought to us by another customer. Shouldn't we have the rights to sell it to other people? It should be our proprietary design. Marketing said they didn't think they could do it. In fact, actually at one point, Stan and I designed another 4-bit processor, and it's another whole story. But finally, marketing decided, and around May of 71, got the rights to sell to other people, but still objected to the idea of announcing the product. But then there was a shakeup at Intel. And a new director of marketing arrived. That was Ed Gelbach, who came to us from Texas Instruments and may have known a little bit about what was going on at Texas Instruments. Mm-hmm. And it wasn't long after Ed arrived that the decision was made to announce the 4004 as an Intel product. And the ad that did it, I don't think we have a slide of it here, but the ad that did it was a pretty impressive ad. It was a large, almost a full-page ad in a magazine called Electronic News. It was like a newspaper that said, announcing a new era of integrated electronics, a micro-programmable computer on a chip.
And TI was getting ready to announce their own at that time, too.
Well, TI had been working with Computer Terminals, yeah. And I learned this much later on, but when they heard that Intel was going to do the Computer Terminals processor as a single chip, TI said they would do the same. But their process wasn't quite as good as ours. So our chip, I think, was about a third of the area of the TI chip. Mm-hmm.